For cycling after dark, you need a headlight. The packaging of bicycle headlights from different manufacturers shows icons that rate their compliance with standards of flashlight performance. In this video, we'll review what these mean and what to look for in a bike light. Light output, stated in lumens, is the first factor we'll look at. A candle radiates approximately 13 lumens in all directions. That means this Brompton light is equivalent to 40 candles. For riding, 100 to 200 lumens makes you visible both day and night in a well-illuminated city environment, what we call a to-be-seen light, but not enough to see with. You'll need 200 to 600 lumens to ride after dark in a moderately lit urban or suburban environment. More than 600 lumens will be required for high-speed road cycling or riding on dark roads and trails. It's important to note that human perception of light intensity is not linear. So doubling a 400 lumen light to 800 lumens will be perceived by the human brain as only a 40% increase in brightness. To actually double the perceived intensity, the light would need to be increased by a factor of 4, or to 1600 lumens. Beam distance, measured in meters, is specified by this icon. This 260 lumen tactical flashlight, for example, has almost the same beam distance, about 200 meters, as this bicycle headlight, which has 1500 lumens. The main difference is the beam dispersion pattern. Beam distance can easily be measured using a tape and a light meter, or even with a smartphone and a light meter application. Light meters measure lux, or the number of lumens per square meter that hits the sensor. Direct sunlight can be up to 100,000 lux, while an overcast sunrise or sunset is about 100 lux, and the light of a full moon is only about one quarter of a lux. A starlit night could be less than 1,000th of a lux. Our eye sensors are divided into daytime and nighttime capabilities. The overlap between the two, or twilight vision, is when we need our bicycle headlights. Beam distance is the maximum distance at which the illumination is equivalent to a full moon, or about one quarter lux. It's easy to calculate the lux value at various distances, multiplying by 4 the lux intensity every time the distance is cut by half. The 10 meter lux value, often used in Europe to rate headlights, can be computed using the beam distance value in this equation. So in this case, we have a 1500 lumen light with a beam range of 195 meters and a 95 lux rating. Peak beam intensity value, measured in candela, is sometimes indicated on the packaging. We can ignore it because it's computed using the beam distance and doesn't give any additional information. While cycling, the 1/4 lux threshold is a pretty low bar to compute maximum beam distance. To be more realistic, estimate about half of the indicated value. Another factor to consider when selecting a light is the age of the rider. Both daytime and twilight vision decrease with age. Daytime acuity usually drops below 1, equivalent to 20/20, around 45 years old. Twilight acuity, which is less than 20/20 even for younger riders, also drops with age. Activity level is also a factor in twilight riding vision. Even a 15-minute ride can generate a noticeable drop in acuity, especially at high-intensity riding, or 200 watts in this research. So fast night riders have even more reason to purchase a powerful headlight. Beam pattern can also be important. Most flashlights, as well as many bicycle headlights, have a circular beam pattern. The variation in intensity between the center of the beam, or hotspot, and the area where the intensity is 50% lower, defines the beam angle. The zone outside this area is called spillover. Here's the beam pattern for a Magic Shine and the Brompton Cat Eye. Notice the differences in the hotspot and spillover. When pointing the beam toward the road, a headlight with a large spillover could blind incoming traffic. Some manufacturers address this problem by providing a cutoff at the top of the beam, or by using two different beam lights. This Raveman uses a type of lens that redistributes the beam horizontally. The resulting pattern can be seen here. German road traffic regulation STVZO addresses the subject of bicycle beam pattern and minimum lux rating. The distinctive beam shape, as seen in this Magic Shine light, needs to meet specific intensity limits at various angles from the hotspot for the headlight to be officially approved. Another important parameter is how long the battery lasts. To measure duration, the light is turned on, and after a 30-second stabilization period, the light intensity is measured and the timer started. When the light intensity reaches 10% of the initial reading, the timer is stopped. Instead of light intensity decreasing gradually over time, the reality is quite different. The total energy available in the battery is proportional to the area under the curve. Through the use of internal circuitry, manufacturers can control the power curve to optimize battery duration. For example, they may set up the power to maintain 1,000 lumens for the first 15 minutes, then switch to echo mode for the next hour and 45 minutes, advertising a runtime of 2 hours. Alternatively, another manufacturer might keep the 1,000 lumens stable until the battery dies, for a total of 45 minutes runtime. A more accurate power curve could be 30 minutes at maximum setting, followed by a gradual drop in the next 30 minutes, for a total of 1 hour runtime. You can get a realistic estimate of the battery duration by looking at its milliamp hours rating. In this example, 3,000 milliamp hours. As a quick rule of thumb, assume a regular LED headlight will need 1,000 milliamps to generate 500 lumens. So a 3,000 milliamp hours battery should generate 500 lumens for 3 hours. LED efficiency is unfortunately not linear. For example, an increase of current from 1,000 milliamps to 3,000 milliamps does not generate 1,500 lumens, but only 1,100 lumens, or about 25% less than expected. So whenever possible, avoid using your LED lights at maximum power setting for a long period of time, as the higher intensity will make it less efficient. In conclusion, 100 to 200 lumens should be sufficient for a to-be-seen light in daytime and well-lit urban nighttime environments. 200 to 600 lumens should provide enough light to see with in a moderately lit nighttime environment. More than 600 lumens will be needed for high-speed road cycling or on unlit roads and trails. To double the perceived illumination level, you will need to quadruple the power rating. Older or fast riders should also take into account visual acuity when selecting the lumen light output. Beam cutoff avoids blinding incoming traffic. This feature is mandatory in some countries. Beam distance is based on the equivalent illumination of a full moon. This is quite optimistic in reality. Assume usable distance will be less than half of what is indicated on the packaging. Advertised battery duration can sometimes be misleading. Using the battery milliamp hours rating provides a better estimate. As a rule of thumb, assume about 1,000 milliamps for every 500 lumens. While touring, we usually make sure we have at least 2 hours of autonomy at 500 lumens. LED lights are inefficient at high power settings. A 1,000 lumen headlight set at medium power would likely be more efficient than a 500 lumen headlight running at full power, even though ultimately both generate the same amount of lumens. We hope this introductory video sheds some light on this important safety subject. In our next video, we'll compare the characteristics of the Brompton branded headlight against similarly priced competitors. We're Pam and Gilbert of Two Bikes for Adventure.